rested and refreshed next morning after Horlicks, more ready for the coming day. Keep a package at home in either natural or chocolate flavor and start drinking it tonight. A cool, refreshing summer drink. You'll find a score of other uses for this famous food drink. No home should be without Horlicks. And now, let's see what's happening down in Pine Ridge. Yesterday, the stockholders of the Great Western Sterling Silver Company held a secret meeting and decided to oust Squire Skimp as general manager of the corporation and prevailed upon Lum to take over the direction of the silver mine. Needless to say, Lum readily accepted the new responsibility, and Squire graciously withdrew in his favor, presenting Lum with his entire holdings in the company, this giving Lum now controlling interest. As we look in on Pine Ridge today, we find Lum over at his home, very much impressed with his own importance. There's someone at the door. Listen.
Come in, come in. Well, good morning, Abner. Come in.
Well, fine too, goodness. What's wrong with you this morning?
What's wrong with me?
Yeah, I allowed you sick or something. Me and Cedric's been sitting down there in the store for 2 hours waiting for you to show up so we can start out on the run.
Well, I'll be dead blamed. I'd forgot all about the store.
Huh?
I aimed to call you last night and tell you all to just go ahead and talk to me today.
Go without you?
Yeah, I've got so much to do here, Abner. I can't be running around town on that store. Being general manager of this silver mine is going to take up all my time, I'm afraid.
Well, now, if you think I'm going to do all the work on that store by myself, you've got another thing coming.
Well, you've got Cedric on there to help you.
Well, he can't do nothing but drive a truck. He can't wait on a trade or nothing else.
Well, maybe we could get Grandpappy Spears to help you.
Well, now, that silver mine ain't going to take up all your time long. Ain't nothing to do except try to find somebody to sell it to.
Yeah, and what if somebody come in here wanting to buy it? Get the inquiring around about where the president and general manager's at and somebody tell him he's out riding around town in a peddling wagon, that wouldn't look right.
Well, that ain't no peddling wagon. It's a rolling grocery store. He jumped all over as a sea trunk for calling it that the other day.
Well, regardless of what it is, the president of a big sterling silver mine can't be going around weighing up for taters and such as that. It ain't becoming.
Well, we get through by noon every day. You'll have all afternoon to see after the mining business, Lum.
Well, the trouble is, I've got to have a place where I can sit down and figure things out. Study up some ideas on how I can put this mine back on a paying base.
Well, can't you study there on the store while we're riding around?
Oh, I'm feared that wouldn't work out, Abner. I've got to have a place where I won't be interrupted. I'd about get a big idea while we was riding along and the truck hit a big bump and bump it right out of my head.
Well, we'll just tell Cedric to drive carefuler from here out so as not to bounce no ideas out of your head.
Yeah, but even at that, we stopped even. I might be having $1 million idea in my head and somebody come in want a dime's worth of cheese. Then all I could think about would be cheese. Just look what we'd lose. That ain't fair to the stockholders.
Well, it ain't fair to me to expect me to do all the work in the store, neither.
Well, that ain't my fault. You're the one that egged me into taking over the management of the silver mine and kicking Squire Skimp out. You and Grandpappy Spears come over there yesterday and said the stockholders wanted me to take charge of it.
Yeah, but I never knowed you was going to use that for excuse to get out of work on a store.
I told you I'd get Grandpappy Spears to help you.
Well, who's going to pay him all?
Who's going Yeah, that's right, ain't it?
If we pay him out of the profits of the store, why, I'll be doing my half of the work and paying for half of what you're supposed to be doing, too.
Yeah, that wouldn't be fair. I can see that.
Why, of course not.
Suppose I might could get the stockholders in the silver mine to pay his wages while I'm devoting my time to the interests of the mine.
Well, I don't know where they will or not, though, Lum.
Well, I've got to call a meeting of the stockholders anyway. Talk to them about buying me some office furniture and stationeries and one thing and another.
Well, now, you're just wasting your time. I can tell you that right now, Lum. They all have invested all the money in this silver mine that they're going to.
Oh, I won't have no trouble putting a deal over. Don't you worry about that.
Yeah, you just ain't talked to them.
Well, see, when Squire turned all that stock of his over to me yesterday and put it in my name, I've got 57% of the stock in my name now. That gives me the controlling interest. Whatever I say goes from here out.
Well, how would they pay for it? We ain't got no treasure to take it out of. Squire took what money there was in the company when he got out.
Yeah, he just let the stockholders pay according to the amount of stock they own. Maybe 10 cents a share or something like that. That's the way I aim to get them to pay my salary, too.
Your salary?
Yeah, I thought I'd put myself on a salary for being president and general manager. Both of them officers together ought to have a salary.
For goodness sake.
Wait a minute, though. I guess that ain't gonna work.
Huh?
Of course not. What's the matter? If we all pay according to how much stock we own, I'll be paying 57% of my own salary. Thanks, I'm going to have to study up some other
way. Well, what we've got to study up now is some way to get that store started today. You ain't going to work. I've got to get somebody else to help me. We can't wait till you have a meeting of the stockholders to find out if you can hire Grandpap or not.
Reckon we could get Grandpap to work for us and just sort of trade it out, take his wages in groceries. Wouldn't cost us nothing that way.
Well, I don't care how you do it, just so I don't have to pay half of it. That's all I'm worrying about.
Leave, I'll call Grandpap and ask you.
No, wait a minute now. Wait a minute, though. That ain't right, Mom. No. If he takes it out and groceries out of the store, well, I'll still be paying him half. If we give him that groceries.
Well, half the groceries is mine, too. Oh, yeah, I see what you mean now. I tell you, just came out of my half of the groceries.
Trouble is, old Lum, we don't know which half is yours and which half is mine.
Yeah, that's right. There ought to be some way to handle that, though. I've got so much silver on my mind, I can't half think for it. That's the trouble with trying to help a fella like Granddad. Hard to deal with. Here he's been begging us ever since we started that store to give him a job, and now then we decide to use him and him causing us all this trouble.
Yeah, he's stubborn.
That's the way it goes. Needing work as bad as he does.
Oh, he's set in his ways, yeah.
I'm a good mind to call him up right now and just tell him. You just let his hard-headedness beat him out of a job.
Yeah, call him up, Lum. Just call him up right now. I know that maybe that'd just learn him a lesson. That's what it'll do.
That's the trouble with folks nowadays. They're too saucy. They won't work, and then when they get quit. Hello, Grandpap? Oh, is Grandpap there? Ain't there? I'll tell him to step to the telephone, please, Mom.
It's just good enough, fine. Very idea. Him trying to get up here. He makes me so mad sometimes I can't hardly stand myself.
You just got to be learning to listen. Hello? Grandpap? This is Lum Edwards talking.
I'll fix it myself, he said.
Yeah, I just called you up to tell you we can get along without you. There's plenty of folks around here wanting work that ain't too short. Huh? Why are they fussing and arguing around here about what we're going to pay you? Maybe we're working in a store down there, helping Abner out. Huh? Come over that again. I didn't quite get you. Well, I'll be dead, but trying to deny the whole thing now. Claimed you never knowed nothing about it.
Well, that's just like it.
Well, you was wanting work, wasn't you? Well, what are you acting so stubborn about what you get paid for then? Huh? Wait a minute here. Somebody's mixed up here.
Yeah, let me talk for a minute, Mom. I'll make him recollect it.
I think the best thing to do is just let it go. Well, glad you called up, Grandpap. Goodbye. Okay, I didn't see him bothering me with a batch of foolishness like that. Many things as I got on my mind.
What are we going to do about the store, Lum? Cedric's sitting down there waiting for me to get back.
I reckon we'll get that. Wait a minute. Somebody's door there.
Yeah, more likely Cedric looking for me now.
Come in. Well, howdy, Squire. Come right in. Come in.
Good morning, gentlemen. Good morning.
Howdy, Squire.
Sit down, Squire. Here, take this rock.
Thank you, Lum.
Lum, I believe I'll go on down there and get Cedric, and we'll drive a store by here, and then we can make up our minds what we're going to do about it.
All right, Emma.
Well, Lum, I brought over the deed to that property out in Arizona that the mine's on. I just had it made over to you as a passing in trustee of the Great Western Southern Silver Company Limited.
Limited?
Yes, that's the term we use in some of the larger companies, you know, so I had that put on there.
Well, good for you.
Now, that fixes everything up, Lum. That gives you full control of the company now. And relieves me of any and all responsibility.
Yeah, I hate that the worst way, Squire.
Well, that's all right, Lum. I don't blame you one bit. Not at all. The stockholders were dissatisfied with the way I was handling things, and I'd make any kind of a sacrifice to show the stockholders that I have their interest at heart, all my good friends here in Pine Ridge.
Yeah, what you did here sure ought to prove to them that you want to do the right thing, all right, Squire. I'll say that
for you. Yes, I thought it would too, Lum. That's the reason I was willing to step down and out and give you my interest just to show them that I was trying to do right.
Well, I say, I think the trouble was when they heard you was going to move to Oklahoma, they just got a little nervous. That's all. Wasn't no hard feeling.
Yes. Well, now, I may change my mind now, Lum, and not move over there at all. I've got a proposition hanging fire, but I haven't made up my mind for certain yet on it. I just want to wind up all my business here so that I can leave right sudden if I have to.
Sure, sure. Well, I hope you stay with us.
So I brought over a letter here that I thought you should copy and send to all the stockholders.
Something for me to send them?
Yes, just advising them that you've taken full charge of the company and that I've got nothing more to do with it.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Yes, let them know who's running things.
Let them know I'm responsible for the whole thing.
Yes.
Yeah, let's see that.
Yes, yes, go ahead, read it, Lum.
To the stockholders of the Great Western Sterling Silver Company. This is to advise you that our former general manager, M.K. Skimp, is no longer connected with the company and that I am taking full charge and assuming all responsibility.
Well, it looks as though the Square has very cleverly shifted all responsibility to Lum's willing shoulders. And now, a final thought before we leave you for tonight. When you go downtown shopping, or when golfing, or motoring, or fishing, be sure and take a flask of Horlick's tablets with you. There's nothing like these wholesome, nourishing tablets for helping ward off hunger or fatigue. When you begin to feel hungry or tired, just dissolve a couple in your mouth. They'll help refresh you, keep you going at full speed when you aren't able to eat on time. Children love Horlick's tablets, too. Love the full, delicious taste of both the natural and chocolate flavors. It's a good idea to let them carry a supply with them on hikes or excursions. Horlick's tablets will keep them from becoming overtired when the rest of the family is off on one of those all-day trips. You can get them, you know, from your druggist in handy 10-cent flasks, or larger sizes if you wish them. This is Carlton Bricker, speaking for Lum and Abner and Horlick, who now bid you all goodbye until tomorrow at the same time.